Marcus. You know, I really hoped it wouldn't come to this. Or maybe I did. You fucked up. If you'd have done this 10 years ago, I would have been shocked. But not anymore. I'm not all too surprised, to be honest. This was just the final straw. I've never been fond of cleaning up other people's messes. But this one might be fun. They're coming. I'm giving you the chance to run against my better judgment, which is more than you deserve. But then again, everyone dies eventually when they cross us. When you started with us, wasn't the first thing you were told, follow your orders and don't fuck up, eh? You had the chance to rise to the top. Why couldn't you have just done what I said like everyone else? Remember when they used to call you Flame Jumper? Because you ran back into the house we burned down to save the little fat kid. Never understood it myself. Should have left him, stupid bastard. You always were a pain. Hard to keep the goons in line when you can't trust your top dog to follow orders. You made all the wrong choices for this line of work. You know, my dad told me a story when I was a kid. His dad had told it to him, and I'll tell it to you. A story about two wolves. You heard it before. Well, it's an old Cherokee chief telling his son that there's a war in your soul. Two wolves inside you. One of these wolves is evil, right? He's all anger, guilt and violence. And the other is good, you know, like happiness, love, all the soppy shit in life. So this boy asks which wolf wins. The chief tells him, the one you feed. Marcus, you fed the wrong wolf.